What's up guys, welcome to another video on the Gaming Careers YouTube channel. My name's Pete and today we are going to be looking at the highly requested AutoDJ feature from Nightbot. Now for those of you that aren't familiar with the AutoDJ feature, what it does is it allows your stream viewers to interact in chat and request songs through the AutoDJ system that automatically play in the background of your stream. So one of your viewers can type in the song request command into your Twitch or YouTube gaming chat, and then after that, request a certain song by pasting in the URL or by using a search term. And that will then search either YouTube, SoundCloud, or Spotify, depending on how you set up the tool, to be able to play that song in the background. AutoDJ then provides you as the streamer with lots of different ways of controlling the music, skipping songs, changing the volume, and setting default playlists to play when there are no requests in the queue. It's a really awesome tool, which is why I've dedicated a whole video to it. And one thing I'm going to mention is if you haven't yet set up Nightbot, you haven't got it to join your channel, you haven't, you know, made it a moderator, then you need to watch the video that I've created on Nightbot. I go into loads of detail into customizing and setting it all up, but you need to have done all of that before you can set up AutoDJ. So if you haven't yet done that, I'll put an annotation up top for the video and also down in the description. Pause this video now, go and watch that, set Nightbot up, and then come back here and we can start playing with AutoDJ. Let's jump in. So, to set up AutoDJ, we need to head over to the Nightbot dashboard, which is nightbot.tv, log in with our Twitch or YouTube accounts. It should already be authorized and you should already have Nightbot in your channel and modded. Again, if you haven't done that yet, please click the link down in the description. Watch our Nightbot setup guide because you need to do that first. Down the left-hand side, we're going to click on Song Requests and then click on AutoDJ. There are three main sections to the AutoDJ page. There are some settings, there's the music player with some controls, and a queue of all the upcoming songs. We'll start with the settings. The Enable/Disable option is fairly obvious, but this is to control whether or not new song requests can be added to the queue from your chat. Clear Queue clears all the songs currently in the queue. The Request Song button, that opens up a pop-up where you can enter a direct URL from YouTube, Spotify, or SoundCloud, or you can enter a search term, and the closest match will be chosen from the search term. The search is provided on the search provider, which we'll be setting up next. The final button up top is the Settings button, which will pop up where you can alter all of the different settings for the AutoDJ feature. These are divided into three main sections. First, we'll look at the general section, which the first option is the user level. Similar to a lot of the Nightbot stuff that we did in the previous video, this is the minimum user level that someone in your chat has to have to be able to request a song. So if you want everyone to be able to request a song, leave this set at everyone. Providers, these are the different services that you want to allow users to request songs from, so you can check or uncheck these boxes as you desire. The playlist option, this is basically when your song request queue is empty and you don't want the music to stop. This is where Nightbot AutoDJ is going to be selecting songs from. So if the queue is completely empty, it's going to be selecting songs from this playlist. The default playlist that they have there is Monster Cat, which is sort of an EDM, sort of electronic, fairly high tempo playlist, which is pretty good actually. And if you select channel here, you'll be able to make your own playlist, and we'll look at setting that up a little later in the video. Finally, under general, we have search provider, and this is the provider that we want to use for searching songs. So if one of your viewers types in !! song request Katy Perry raw, Nightbot will use this search provider that you set here to find the song. Just as a side note, no matter which provider you set here, viewers will still be able to request songs using the song URL on YouTube, SoundCloud, or Spotify. This is just the search provider if they enter a search term rather than a URL. The next category of settings is limits, and the first option that we have is queue length. This is the maximum amount of songs that can be stored in the queue, and it can be anything between 1 and 100. I just set this at 100. The limit to playlist option, if you enable this, it will force song requests to have to be in the playlist that you have set up, either Monster Cat or your own. I honestly don't know why you would do this. It kind of ruins the fun of users being able to request songs, but maybe if you've got a massive playlist, and users want to request songs from that, then you can enable this here. User limit is the maximum number of songs that a user can request at a time. This can be anything between 1 and 100. I'd personally leave this at 2. And the exempt user level, this is the minimum user level that someone has to be exempt from all of these limits. The final settings section is YouTube. You can basically, firstly, limit the requests to be tagged as music. So if you enable this, this will only add requested songs to the queue if they are tagged in the music category on YouTube. Limit to liked videos. This will only add requested songs to the queue if the video has more likes than dislikes on YouTube. So if one of your users, one of your viewers is requesting Justin Bieber's Baby, at the time of recording this video, that wouldn't be added if you had this option enabled because it has more dislikes than likes. So that's it for settings. Next, we'll move on to the players and controls. The music player itself will change automatically between the providers that you've enabled. So by default, this will be YouTube, SoundCloud, and Spotify. And it will change based on where the song request has come from. You also get some information next to the player, such as the title of the track, the length, a link to the song, and the name of who in your chat requested the song. Controls-wise, you'll be able to pause and play, skip to the next song in the queue, as well as skip ahead to a different part of the current song, and of course, change the volume. Obviously, I recommend playing around with the volume here to make sure that it's a good level for both you whilst you're playing games and for your stream viewers. Finally, we'll move on to the queue. The queue is where you can see an ordered list of the upcoming songs and requests for your stream. When you have no song requests, you'll just see the upcoming songs from either the Monster Cat playlist or your own playlist. To demonstrate how this changes when a user requests a song, we'll head over to our Twitch chat, type in !SongRequest, and then paste in a YouTube URL of a song that we'd like to request. If we wait just a few seconds, we should see the requested song appearing at the top of our queue of requested songs. It's worth noting here that this appears above all of the other playlist songs, which are coloured in grey, that haven't been requested. Requested songs will always take priority over the default playlist ones. Let's do another quick demonstration to show the search. If we go to our Twitch chat again and type in !SongRequest and then something like Wiz Khalifa, see you again, Nightbot's AutoDJ feature will search the search provider that we set up for the song and add the most likely result to the queue. Now we can see both of the songs here in the upcoming songs queue, along with who requested them. We have a couple of buttons on the right-hand side here, which allow us to promote a song up the list to be first in the queue, as well as an option to delete a song from the queue. That's pretty much it for the AutoDJ page. Next, we'll look at setting up an alternative default playlist to the Monster Cat one, which is there by default. So if you want AutoDJ to play songs from one of your handcrafted playlists rather than the default one, whilst there are no requests in the queue, firstly, you need to jump back into the settings quickly and change the playlist from Monster Cat to Channel and click Submit. Next, we'll head over to the left-hand side and click on the playlist option. Here you can set up your playlist either by adding individual songs or by importing a whole playlist from YouTube, SoundCloud, or Spotify. To demonstrate this, I'm going to import a playlist that I love listening to whilst I stream, and that's by Mr. Suicide Sheep, and it's from Spotify. To import a playlist, all we have to do is click the import button up here, copy the playlist URL from YouTube, SoundCloud, or Spotify, paste it in here, and click submit. It may take a few seconds to import depending on the size of the playlist, how many songs there are inside of it, but once it has, you should see all of the songs displayed below. You can then remove or add individual songs if you'd like, or you can import even more playlists on top of this if you want to have a massive selection to choose from. It's worth mentioning what I think is fairly obvious here to prevent the influx of comments that I'm sure I'd get if I didn't mention it. You need to have the AutoDJ page open whilst you stream to be able to hear any of the music, because this is actually where the music is coming from. If you're wanting to use Spotify for some of your requests, then you're going to need to download the Nightbot app, which we're going to cover now. The Nightbot app is just an application version of the website that Nightbot have built, and it allows you to do a couple of things specifically to do with AutoDJ. Firstly, as I just mentioned, if you want to use Spotify, you need to have the app, since that's just a limitation of the Spotify web player. You need to be having the app and using the Spotify desktop client. Secondly, if you want to be displaying the now playing song information, as well as things like who requested it, actually on your stream, then you're going to need to download the app, since it generates a text file that we can import into OBS. The third reason for downloading the app is that it allows you to use hotkeys on your keyboard to skip, pause, and change volume of the AutoDJ. Obviously, when you're streaming, you want to have as many of these hotkeys set up as possible so you don't have to keep alt-tabbing and changing settings individually. So what we need to do is download the Nightbot app. They have one both for Windows and OS X. I've added a link in the description below to the page where you can download it from. Download and install as you normally would with any other program, and we'll walk through setting up the now playing text. When you launch it for the first time, you're going to need to log in and authorize with your Twitch or YouTube account. Once you've logged in, you're going to notice that it looks exactly like the Nightbot website. It has all of the same features down the left-hand side. So if we go to Song Requests and then Auto DJ and click Settings button in the top right, you'll see that we have a new setting to edit that is called Nightbot App. This is where you can edit the format of the text generated into the text file that we'll be importing into OBS. So you can see that the default is the song title and then who requested it. If you want to edit this to include maybe the artist, you simply just use the artist variable, which is shown below. Now, by default, the app outputs a text file to a specific location that I'm showing on screen now. They're different for PC and Mac, so make sure that you're looking in the right folder. To set this up in OBS, firstly, let's start playing a song through the AutoDJ section of the app, and then we'll swap to OBS Studio. Select the scene which you want to add the now playing text into, then go across to Sources, click the plus button, then select text and name it something that we're going to be able to remember later. I'm going to name mine Music Scroller. Check the Read from File box and then click Browse and navigate to the folder where the Nightbot application is outputting the text file. Again, the defaults are shown below. Once you've opened the text file, you should see the song information displaying. You can then edit this however you want to, change the font, change the color, change the font size, play around with backgrounds, all that kind of stuff. Once you're happy with how your text is looking, click OK and we should see the text displaying inside of OBS. Position this wherever you want to position it and make sure you've got the font size correct and all those kind of things. If you want to have the text scrolling, you're going to need to add a scroll filter to the text. So to do this, right click on the text source and select filters. Click the plus button and add the scroll filter to the text. Then all we need to do is adjust the horizontal scroll speed to whatever you think looks good. You'll also probably want to use the limit width, which limits the width of the text box to a set amount, which makes positioning your now playing text somewhere on your stream much easier. As you can see, you can get something set up fairly quickly, which looks really good and is super interactive with your viewers. They can request songs through chat. They can see that they've requested it on your stream. They can hear it. You get to react with what kind of song is playing. It's a super interactive way and a great way to bond with your chat. Some quick final things to mention. If you are using Spotify and having any issues at all, then you need to go to the help page that I've also linked below. It's right below the download links that you opened earlier. There's some specific quirks with Spotify. You have to open Spotify first, then the Nightbot application, but they've got some troubleshooting on there. Secondly, I just want to reiterate to prevent any kind of questions on this, you need to have the Nightbot website open if you're using the website or the Nightbot app open if you're using the app to be able to use this whole AutoDJ function. That's pretty much it, guys. So if you have enjoyed the video and you've got to this point, please do give it a thumbs up. It really does help us out, and maybe share the video with somebody else that's learning to stream. Also, if you're new to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, we are a YouTube channel completely dedicated to helping you succeed with Twitch, YouTube gaming, live streaming, content creation. So have a look around the channel and subscribe if you haven't already. Subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.